life story based on what's being fed into internet, in cyberspace. That's a whole nother reality. So that virtual reality and history and the use of the internet is going to have to be a whole nother level of what we call cyberspace and the various levels of cyberspace and how you are used physically in the biological versus artificial intelligence. And a lot of people are haters and they want to look for things to hate, including cyborgs. And we shouldn't be hating anything. This love-hate relationship with what we're going to put into the computer or not. And there's various people that feel like they're policing, including a nonprofit called Wikipedia. Okay, and I do support and give money to Wikipedia, although I've never really written an article for Wikipedia. And so we're going to have a history of Wikipedia. And with that, there's a history back to how all these various browsers, and many people don't even know what a browser is. And I'm recently helping Ken Johnston Sr. His name is Ralph Kennedy Johnston with a T. Senior, not junior now, because he says his son doesn't want the mixture. But Ken was going to do the Mars One. We have a group going historically, the Mars One group going to Mars. So there's a whole history being written by people on the inside scientifically and being chosen to go into space. Now that needs to be a class of Ufology 101, separate from these that are telling stories off the top of their mind and thinking that they are part of the virtual reality or the physical three-dimensional biological reality and mixing them just like we do in Hollywood. So that's a class. And I'm going to let Ken R. Johnston help with Ufology 101 because there's the reality and he's fixing to pass on and many of our astronauts have passed on, and there's a true reality there in Ufology 101 that we did go into space, and Sputnik, Russians put that up, and that really put a scare in us. So a lot of these conferences are picking up the history, actually from Kennedy, but forward, but we need to go even farther back to World War II and prior to that. So there's decades and the eras, which are politically and we'll just say they're political and they're religious, meaning that the church and state have something to do with that in Ufology 101. So that needs to be, how do we track our own Ufology 101 history? And we're going to write Ufology 101 in our group and with me. And I claimed it on Facebook a long time ago. I just haven't gotten back to it. And I had, while my husband passed, I had given it over to Javier Sandoval from California because he came on my TJ Mars ET radio and wanted to help me in the future. And my husband died. And then another gentleman that was with him, sort of his backer, they went to outside of Sedona and created a place in a Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints church. I guess it didn't work there. And I understood they rented it from the Latter-day Saints. So that right there and what he did, and during that time, Senator McCain died. And so Javier has built a story. And his aunt, apparently, now I have not vetted and done a complete investigation on that, but for sake of sanity in Arizona, Ufology 101 has a story with Sedona and how the Ascension Centers were to be real. And he took the stories from TJMR CT Radio and me personally and created a whole reality in a building which can be verified. So Ufology 101 in 2018, we did try to combine the Ascension Center with higher meditation and New Age, I guess, or Sedona. And now I just mentioned 5D reality because people are trying to find out how to speak about the future and dimensions in their own reality, which has become a mixture of books written in New Age, occult metaphysical, spirituality, and psychology or parapsychology. And this is something that we need to look at for how are we going to help people understand themselves emotionally, mentally, physically, spiritually, educationally, psychologically. And we can go back and look at Gaia, not the new maybe come and gone place in space. They have something that they're doing, but Gaia was another name for Mother Earth. And we had Father God and Mother Earth. So that is a spiritual track that is spoken by many people from the old history that we created, even since I've been here on Earth, but they took a lot of the history of the Father God and Mother Earth and combined it, and they've sort of used all world religions and brought it up to even what I had in my book called Ascension Psychic Awakening Classes. Now, I'm not saying it's bad. I'm just saying that it is combined and it's a part of Ufology 101. So that's sort of where your metaphysical woo-woo comes in. And so we share information with each other, and we come together in various groups and gatherings and seminars and workshops, and we create CDs and webinars where everybody helps each other. And it's really a lot of fun to do these conferences or events, and we plan those. So Ufology 101 was supposed to be about events and planning, and it got off the track. And so what I'm learning is people that I've helped on the planet in Ufology 101 may get sidetracked for whatever reason. There's no blame game here, okay? I'm not blaming anybody. I'm just saying that as those that came to me as a life coach and a spiritual guide are with ET Spirit Guide shows where I would do readings free for people on radio versus those that in the future are going to have to pay me for my time because they have duped me. And you can relate in Ufology 101 that there are people that will think they are helping you, or they may by choice choose to tell you they are and then take all your information and use it for their own gain. Now, this isn't going to stop just because I made this Ufology 101 radio show or whatever it is. I'm not even sure at this point because I've never made one like this. I'm using a totally new screen. It's like a cPanel in website development or for developers, but this is my studio, and it's provided by a pro plan valid into 2019, and I have a 94% audio storage, and I've just started, so 500 hours I think I've gotten total, and I've somehow upload audio storage is 94%. So being that I am learning to be a broadcaster with presently in this reality in 3D with TJ Morris ET Radio, I began broadcasting roughly June 3rd to June 6, 2012. And that was going to be TJ Morris ET Radio presenting Stargate to the Cosmos, as well as working with Mutual UFO Network, which is MUFON. I got an advertisement from the captain down when we were moving the UFO, it's Mutual UFO Network, which is just one of many now, and you need to know that because there's a history before that with APRO, and then we have QFOs and a lot of others, and then there's the websites versus the original organizations based on, hopefully, finding a fact But I've learned that that's not exactly what happened. So that right there needs to be a class. Then we have what's happening now with various groups and various names that are being asked to speak at conferences. But I will tell you that there are some people I align with, only maybe 1%, but there's 99% that we're never going to really understand. So you have to learn yourself how to discern and how to move forward in this reality. And politics and religion are going to be there. They're just tracks you can decide to use in Ufology 101. And those are choices. But I'd like you to rise above and take on education and history historically, and then decide in culture, because we have pop culture, folk culture, and cultural events, and those that are in the now. So we're going to do a whole in the now, and being here now as a, I don't think you would call it philosophy, but we're going to call it, for lack of better words, the path with an opened walk, which with our TJMRCT radio, Bill M. Tracer has developed with the opened walk, OpenedWalk, and he has made another group for us. We have so many social media groups through the years, I can't even get to them. So social media groups and in business is very important now. So we were saying that we would like every business in cyberspace to have a website. We'd like every person to have at least a page. And so Facebook started offering everything that other companies were offering, and it's gotten to be quite competitive. And now we'll see Facebook and Microsoft and Google as names we see every day. We don't pay much attention to Acrobat or to flash drives, and those may or may not go away. But that may be a combination between what we use as tools and computers and software. So basically, we're going to have to discuss how we are using our mind in the open brain, open mind, open walk, and how we discern the hard drive from the software package, and how we're using that in today's reality. So reality in Ufology 101 is extremely important, because it's part of the Be Here Now program. And what do you use now? And that includes your cell phones, okay? Because now I can come forward and show how I am learning with those that want to know how we're combining the baby boomers. And this is, I'm going to tell you that we need a class on how to work with our genome, but also we don't throw the baby out with the bathwater in Ufology 101. In other words, we're not going to get rid of our old people, our old sages, our old mystics, oracles, psychic sages, and seers, just because they're now over the hill and baby boomers are older. So, you know, I was living from 1951, December 26th, basically. I was only 4 days. So 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 5 days old when we entered 1952. So thank you for letting me come down into a biological, at least to get 1952 to hopefully immortality will set in, and I don't have to worry about being a baby boomer anymore. But that needs to be a class on, we don't want in our movies getting rid of the old people. We want the movies, Hollywood and theater, to bring back the old guys, because just like in Men in Black, the movie, that's a good one, is that you can go out and research about all the aliens in our alienology classes. We have alienology now, and that needs to be a separate class, because it, not only in the movies are there aliens, but in people's mind that are creating in virtual reality, what's going out in the internet and in books, they're creating stories, and somehow We will.